I remember getting to Cornell and talking with gift officers about developing relationships digitally. And some people really didn't like that idea. And then people would kind of pull me aside and say, you know, I've been here long enough where I can remember being in a boardroom and people saying, you know, I know a lot of people are starting to use this email thing, but this will never be a way we communicate with our high profile donors. It's just too informal. You know, I think with the explosion of technology and how everything has accelerated faster than ever, everyone's walking around with a TV station in their pocket. I think we've had to kind of embrace, or I hope we continue to embrace, this idea of a more casual communication with our biggest benefactors, and being okay with that and understanding that, you know, there's opportunity with that as well, assuming everyone's okay with it.
12 months ago, if you got caught trying to raise a major gift donation over Zoom, you likely would have been relieved. And today it's just commonplace because, you know, it has been driven that way. And to your point, I think a lot of high net worth donors are excited by the fact that they can get through a 30-minute phone call, do their donation, and not sit through an hour and a half lunch or a 2-hour dinner and have the rest of their day back.
I absolutely agree. And the shift of how we communicate with donors has really changed over the last several years. And I think the mentality shift that you're talking about, Keith, has also changed in the industry, of this hesitation to have a more casual relationship with donors, to now I'm seeing in my own work and in the work of my colleagues, that's actually more of the gold standard, you know, of, you know, if you get to a texting relationship with a donor, that's a great thing. It's kind of similar to a donor welcoming you into their home and welcoming you into their world. That is a really deep engagement opportunity, as opposed to having kind of a snail mail formal relationship where you address letters to Mr. and Mrs. I'm thinking about how their philanthropy impacts the rest of their life. I think that that's a huge added benefit to technology, is the capacity of one's network being so much larger, and there's less geographical scope and limitations on how we can connect with one another.
Yeah, you know, I think in the past, when maybe donors, especially, you know, major gift, principal gift level donors, have valued formality, I think we're seeing a shift where people value their time. And if they can get down to business over text versus having to clear an hour and a half off their schedule to have lunch with me, I think that's almost preferred in a lot of ways. People are busy. We're all busier, and we've kind of just gotten used to doing business electronically and just getting things done. You know, there's always going to be a place for that more formal meeting where you're looking to close something or you're having a discussion about a really transformational gift. You know, that will probably continue to be important.
If we allow technology to supersede the importance of building genuine connection and relationships, that's where we will be beholden to the systems, as opposed to allowing the tools and the systems that were created to serve us.
I actually see some people in the advancement world who are letting technology actually degrade their relationship. And they're turning the fundraising into purely transaction, because it is easy to get done, it is easy to get through. And you don't see people as much sending the handwritten thank you notes out, or the other touch points that Leo was talking about building, where you just text people. And I think there's a huge danger there if you just let technology kind of run your fundraising, that you're end up going to losing not only your major donors, but just really good donors along the way. You know, when we talk about AI, I don't believe in the Terminator. I don't believe that there's a self-living AI out there that's going to just tell you what to do and is going to go do fundraising for you. The real power is that human AI team. And I think it's the same thing with technology. The technology is not there to in any way replace major gift officers or major gift teams, but really empower them to build that relationship that you were talking about, Leah.
What I hope does not change, or what I hope that we continue to hold fast to, is that just the fundamental principle that donors don't owe the organization anything. That every time a donor decides to make a gift, that is a personal decision that they're making, that they don't need to make. And so our responsibility as major gift officers, as fundraisers, is to develop meaningful relationships between the donor and the impact that they're making with their giving, and perhaps shift the mentality from this person is a donor to this person is a partner. They're an investor that, you know, they're giving something to the organization, but the organization also has the capacity to give something to the donor. I see that, you know, my role as a gift officer is to help people live out their calling for making the world a better place. The most important thing is to remind ourselves of the why donors are giving, and then help the donor remember the why of why they're giving.